I'm starving.
I don't want ball sauce. I'll just have the
fucking... Speaking of ball sauce, Crazed is here today?
Yes.
Send him in to waste my fucking day. This is what we get because the internet's fucking dark crazed.
It's the crazed one.
Did we get him pizza now?
No, we haven't gotten
him
pizza.
We're going to get that meat lover's pizza from downtown. It was going to be all great for him. Make it like a special day for him.
Crazed.
It's Credouzel.
What's up?
What do you say?
C-Dog.
What's up?
Everybody knows C-Dog.
What's up?
Hey, Crazed.
It's Crazed.
What's up?
What's up, Crazed? Yeah.
Crazed, we were just having a conversation, gay, not gay. Now, I know you've been accused before, right?
Yeah.
Well, now, why do people accuse you of being gay?
Because the reason being is they say that my voice is extremely high, like on the phone.
Right.
Or like... It's, you know, I have the tendency to have like a little bit of a high pitched voice on the phone or if I'm talking on the computer, you know.
To be like, hey, what are you wearing? I want to fuck you or whatever, you know, like.
No, not even that. I don't even have anything. I'm strictly about the ladies, dude.
First of all, Grace, how's the DJ coming along? You still doing that?
No. I mean, it's just a wannabe dream, right. Ronnie. You know, I mean...
Two turntables and a microphone.
Where's it at?
You still love house music, though, right?
Yes, I love house music.
Are you into dubstep at all? Is that happening for you, or...?
Dubstep is horrible, Ronnie. It's just noise.
Right.
You know, it's just like womp 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 womp.
You don't need
womp,
that shit.
Womp 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 womp. That shit gives me a headache.
You need melody. You're a melody maker. Let's go over to Richard. Richard, you're on my face.
What's up, guys? Fezzy, I think you've got this thing all wrong. You're calling football and stuff like that, different sports, gay. I don't think you're looking for the word gay. I think you're looking for the term homoerotic.
Now, do you find football to be homoerotic, Richard?
It turns me on. Is that gay or homoerotic?
Now, what part of it turns you on? I'm being serious here, and I hope you are.
Well, I mean, my favorite, I am a homosexual man. I just, you know, tight pants, bending over.
By the way, nobody gets more ballet pants than those fucking Ravens. I mean, whatever happened to pads, too? There's no knee pads, thigh pads, hip pads. It's just these ballet pants. And no wonder these guys get fucking hurt so much.
They don't give a fuck.
No, they don't.
Jesus.
Now, the other thing about being gay, Richard... is can you be gay without gay sex?
No, not officially, I don't think. I mean, that would, I don't know, I guess so, because I considered myself gay before I had gay sex, yes.
Did you have heterosex before?
No, not intercourse, no.
No, but just fooling around when you were younger?
Yeah, yeah.
And it just felt like, oh, this is dull.
No, I enjoyed it at the time, and then right. I grew up a little bit, and, you know, things change.
Now, I wonder if, like, that could be enjoyable. If, like, Zeets and Crazed made out right now, I mean, knowing that they're two straight guys, what do you think,
no.
Crazed? You, why? Just as an experiment.
I'm strictly for the ladies, man. I'm strictly for the ladies.
I couldn't
do that.
How many ladies have you been with, sexually?
I don't know, maybe four, five.
Non-prostitutes.
Okay, none.
Okay, so you basically, you're not so much straight as you are John.
I'm straight as can be, man. It's just I have a hard time finding a woman, you know? Mm. I mean, I'm sort of in a relationship now with a beautiful woman, but... the fact is...
Crazy, hold on. You can't drop a bomb on like this without fucking getting some details. Who's this beautiful woman? Where'd you meet her? Internet?
No, she's in a group that I'm in a group with.
Ben?
For people dealing with jobs, you know, either trying to find a job, dealing with the stresses of a job, etc.
Right.
And basically... Because the Walmart job, I flipped out, and that's how I...
Well, somebody ate your fucking sandwich, though.
Yeah.
It stole from you.
No, did the same thing happen to her? Somebody eat her sandwich?
No, didn't I eat my sandwich? Threw out my sandwich.
That makes me furious. Yeah. Now, what happened to your new girlfriend? Somebody threw out her sandwich, or what happened?
The thing is, you know, she's been playing little games with me, which I don't like. She, first date, she brings this guy along
That's a red flag.
Yeah, I know. And because she didn't trust me right away, you know? And I thought that was kind of fucked up. She brought a cock blocker.
Right.
You know, so I was...
How far did that go with the three of you, Minaj?
Well, I treated her out, but I didn't treat the other guy.
Nice.
Because he ain't good. My date.
Good one.
Yeah. Block your cock.
So what'd you treat her out doing?
I took her out to her favorite restaurant, some Italian restaurant. I forgot what it was, where she is from. And then I basically went bowling with her.
Mm-hmm.
And then we went for a couple of drinks. And then the fucking douche, the guy over there,
right,
puts his head on the table. And then he stopped allowing us to have drinks, Ronnie. Can you believe that?
Because he was so tired.
Because he was so tired, and he thought he was drunk.
Oh, so second date, how'd that go?
Second date, she stood me up.
Okay.
Oh.
Sorry, another red flag, right? Third date.
Haven't gone for a third date yet.
No, this girl, though, you got feelings for her.
Are these feelings love? I think she's cute, Ronnie.
You in love.
I like her, but, you know, it's like, I think she's selfish.
Would you marry her right now if she said yes?
probably not, Ronnie, because the thing is, we're in the stage of just getting to know each other.
Right. But if you had the opportunity, like if you found out she had brain cancer and she was going to die soon, would you marry her to give her that?
I guess so. If she wasn't going to last long and whatnot, yeah, I mean.
Would you let her die in your arms?
Ronnie, these are pretty serious fucked up questions.
Because here's where I think we are right now, dude. It's time for you to fucking, I'm talking to you as a friend.
Yeah.
I think you're in love, man. I think you found the fucking right girl.
Seems serious.
And that guy, that weird guy. You found the right girl and guy that you've been looking for a long time.
Get weird.
Fucking strange.
Well, I don't want the other guy involved with this. That's the thing, you know? I don't want him involved. I want him to go away, actually.
Now, Fez, when you hear this, you're a guy who hasn't done any dating.
Right.
So when you hear Crazy's stories, do you look up to him or are you looking down on him?
No, I'm looking up. Crazy's out there. Crazy's found somebody.
And another person that he doesn't want, though.
Yeah, that's tricky.
You're actually feeling like Craze is doing fucking better than you.
He's grades above me in the relationship department.
I never thought I'd hear that. This fucking makes me see you in a whole new way, Fezzy. When I see what the Sea Dog is doing, this fucking girl, this could be it, dude. Now, what kind of work is she looking for?
I don't know anything that'll pay her, you know. Or
what did she do? What was her last job?
I think she was. I'm not quite sure, actually.
What'd she bench? She's a strong girl. She big girl.
She's pretty strong, but I don't think she works out. She's just
thick.
She's just thick, big boned.
Yeah,
you know?
Big fucking giant back like a bull's back.
Right. I mean, she's not fat, but she's strong. Like
Russian big.
Yeah.
Yeah, big fucking strong back. Fucking.
Yeah, she's strong.
Tear a fucking foam ball.
Yeah.
Oh hell yeah. Just juiced.
What about the other dude that you've been dating?
I'm not dating.
Well, you're talking
about
on one fucking date.
Yeah.
I'm not dating on a
fucking.
I'm not dating a fucking dude.
How does she know him? What's their relationship?
We both know each other all from the group.
Everybody blows each other. Fez, this is not any, the thing is, let's not judge people,
it's
all
a
right?
Swinger thing.
Just trying
it's
to learn.
It's a fucking menage.
There's no fucking menage here. I'm not going down on no other dude or
not anymore.
Whatever. I'm not even fucking touching him. I don't even want to touch him. He's
Christ.
Like in his
you bowled with him, though.
50s, for Christ's sake.
What if he was younger? What if he was 30? You suck that dick?
Fuck no.
Okay,
that girl was such a cock block on
fuck
that date.
Fuck no.
I'm liking this fucking, you know, story. I'm feeling like it's happening. And Fez, you're looking up to Crazed right now.
Yeah, I think, yeah, Crazed is doing it.
Do you feel crazed, closer to Crazed or Zito?
Oh, Crazed.
why did you laugh, Crazed?
Why did I laugh? I don't know. It's like one of those nervous laughs.
He's having a fucking nervous laugh.
Yeah, come on. Yeah. He's baring his soul right now.
Yeah, sort of, I guess. Yeah. I mean, I like her. That's the extent of it, you know? I mean...
Do you and Fez want to massage each other's shoulders?
You could do that.
No.
That would be too far for you.
That would be too gay. No.
And gay is disgusting, right? I mean, it's
like... I'm not saying it's disgusting, Ronnie.
You love to say it, then.
It's just not for me.
But you love watching it.
No.
Thinking about it.
No, no, no.
Well, then what turns you off about it?
I'm strictly for the women, you know? Mm. I love women, and that's it, you know? I'll hang out with guys or whatever, you know, and we'll chill, but, you know, I'm strictly for the women, then.
Here's Joe in Philadelphia.
Going out to eat with a guy friend doesn't make you gay. However, eating out a guy friend does make you gay.
New rule.
Good point.
Now, Fez did this thing where he said, being straight or being gay, it just, that is, it depends on who you have sex with.
Yeah.
Doesn't that push the born this way thing out the fucking window once and forever?
That means that I mean, Lady Gaga,
yeah,
totally wrong.
I mean, if Chris Stanley now, at this point in his life, decided to start dating a guy, and him and that guy started having fucking fancy guy gay sex,
yeah,
he would then be gay, right?
Yes.
But even though now he's straight. So he wasn't born that way at all.
I just decide, hey, maybe I'll try some cocktails. I guess I'm gay now.
All right, but here's the thing. You look like a French-Canadian lumberjack. I mean, the only gay date I can see on is saying who axes through a tree first.
Timber!
Yeah, see, yeah. That's what you yell out. That's the fucking what gay guys yell. When they come, they yell timber.
No, no.
If you fucked a guy on a golf course, we'd go four.
And honestly, I don't think football is gay at all. I mean, you get a bunch of guys just slamming it into each other,
right?
At full speed, knocking each other unconscious.
That's gay.
That's not gay.
That sounds like gay. You just said slamming it into each other.
Yeah.
No, I didn't say slamming it into each other. I meant literally bashing into each other.
Oh, like
no.
Are you Giants or Jets?
No. I don't know.
That's gay.
I actually don't really watch
it. That's gay. If you don't watch it.
If you don't watch it, then you're definitely...
Then you're definitely gay.
No, I'm not. I'm not gay.
You accept it. It's a good place for you.
No, I'm not gay.
Do you get your lunch today?
Not yet.
You're hoping to, right?
Yeah.
What are you hoping to get?
I don't know. Some nice vegan meal.
Man, I love vegan meal.
Yeah.
Vegan meats?
Sure. Vegan meats. As long as they're made out of tofu.
Somebody sent this in to Zito. It says, going to Austin with my boy for South by Southwest, and we plan on fucking every broad in town. He lives in the Keys. I live in Philly. Eat a dick, fucko. At least I'm not taking a fucking dude to a wedding as a plus one.
Well, statistically, sir, it's improbable you're going to fuck every broad. So there.
The other thing... His friend lives in Key West. This guy's from Philly, the city of brotherly love. And where are they going? Austin!
A fairy Texas town.
Austin!
Love Austin.
Do you think gay guys will ever be accepted by straight guys, Christ?
I accept them, but I just don't want them to touch me.
There was a thing, and it's going to cost me a corner, but I said saw it online, and they were showing kids bronies and thinking it was funny why the kids were going, oh, why would any man, what are they? And it's almost like no one taught them that. They're like little kids, but they think bronies are fucking weird. You do too?
What?
You think a bronie is weird?
I don't even know what a brony is, actually.
It means you're gay.
Then no.
Then maybe you're a little gay.
I'm definitely not gay.
Okay. If a guy tried to pick you up, would you swing at him? Would you try to fight him?
Probably.
Now, if a girl that you didn't like tried to pick you up, would you want to fight with her?
No.
All right, one of us here, and only one of us, has ever had a broomstick in his ass, and that's you, Crazed.
Well, some guy actually put it there accidentally. How does a broom accidentally go up your ass?
That's a lucky shot, then.
No, he thought it would be funny.
Pulls it in like gravity.
No, he thought it would be funny. Because my pants were down just a little bit.
Like, fuck me.
And it put it right in my ass.
Like, I'm gonna tease you.
But I thought that was just like a total faggot move.
Oh, I thought you were accepting.
Oh, dog dropping it.
I am accepting. I just don't like people
what kind of
going
total,
near my ass.
What kind of total move was it?
It was a total faggot move.
Should I jump out of this?
To do it or to receive it?
What kind of move was it?
I didn't enjoy it.
What kind of move was it, Crazed?
I didn't enjoy it.
A total what?
Faggot move.
Oh! Crazed, that is so wrong.
Let's go over here. Patrick. Patrick, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, I got a question for Fezzy.
Yeah.
Yes.
If you said earlier that who you have sex with decides whether you're gay or straight. So what are you?
Fez, you haven't dated yet.
No, I haven't dated. Haven't done anything in that realm.
You haven't had puppy love or anything like when you were 16?
You trying to say fuck the dog?
No.
He's like a virgin.
No, puppy love. You know, you meet a girl for your first time when you're like 10 years old, and you say you're going steady, and you just like yeah, we're going steady. This is awesome. Yeah, but no sex really happens. You know.
But you know what? I want to tell you the truth. I almost think it's wrong to call puppy love because, like, when I was a little kid. And I get my heart broken. It feels the same way as when I was an adult.
Yeah.
I got my heart broken.
I hear you.
I'm like, Jesus Christ, this hurts. This fucking hurts.
Crushing.
Why doesn't she want to go with me anymore?
Because she
Why is she
you.
Going with him?
Because she's the worst person ever.
But to tell you the truth, actually, when I was 10 years old, it was pretty fucked up. This girl wanted to have sex with me, and she wanted to have babies with me. Right. And I was 10 years old, and I'm like, I don't want to have sex or have babies. I'm 10 years old, and I just want to be a kid.
And this was like yesterday.
No.
Crazed. If I could have seen you when you were fucking 10 years old, I never would have stopped laughing. I mean, you were a fucking character.
I was.
I think he would have been a great dad.
I was kind of a weird kid, right?
No.
How?
And what? Why were you weird?
I don't know. I was picked on a lot, you know.
For what?
People would call me Looney Toony.
What the fuck for? Why would they call you Looney Toony, dude?
Because I was just like, I was a little out there, you know. I didn't even really fit in, you know. I just
what?
Was like, just did my own thing. I had like, I'm not racist, but I get scared when people come behind me because back in the day, I'd have big, tall, like 6'3" black guys come and smack me in the back of my head as they were going to hand in their homework.
Ah, Looney Toony, I'm sorry.
Are you not?
What were 6'3" guys doing with another fucking 10-year-old?
No, this was like in high school. We're going up, but I
this
mean,
is when you're in your 30s.
But I mean, no.
Why would they hit you,
Looney?
No,
I wasn't in my 30s. I'm in my 30s now. When I was a teenager.
Why were they hitting you? What did you do?
LT.
They didn't. They thought it was funny. They thought it was funny to pick on a little guy. Whatever.
Terrified back?
Well, by the time they smacked me in the back of my head, the teacher was looking at me, and so I didn't have a chance to fight back. You know?
Why didn't you fucking Columbine that whole place?
They set a fire.
I don't know. I was a pussy when I was a kid.
No,
believe it
dude,
or not.
I don't believe it, man. Not you, LT. Not Looney Toony.
Looney Toony, LT.
That's awful, dude.
See, I was picked on. I was fucked with, but whatever.
See, it's like I told you, Fez. Everybody gets bullied. And look at him. Crazed is fucking doing great. He's in a fucking group right now. Mm-hmm. Talking about how stressful it is not to be working, you fucking meeting chicks and guys.
Yeah, it's just a support group. That's all it is.
Yeah. What do you guys talk about in there? Let's pretend we're in the support group right now. Like, hey, how's everybody doing? Like,
just basically, basically, it's like, I sent in applications to this one. I sent in applications to this one. I still haven't heard back yet. It's still fucked up. The economy's fucked up. We can't find a job. Blah, 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 blah. That's all I hear, usually.
Mm. Then a black guy comes over and smacks you in the back of the head?
Nah. No black guys in my group. But all I'll say is Jamaican rum will fuck you up.
Oh, yeah. No kidding.
Yeah.
Let's go over here to Rob. Go ahead, Rob.
Hey, what's up, Ronnie? Hey. Fezzy, I got a quick question for you.
Sure.
Would you ever get an escort for your first time?
No, it's that doesn't interest me. In just the anonymous sex for a night. I feel like I'd rather have like a relationship going on. That makes me very, very nervous.
Well, don't you wish you had something on your list? Like in your past? Like, so we say, hey, how many people you been with? You could be like five. And I go, how many were non-whores? Oh, none.
None.
You know, like Crazed.
Right.
Like you're saying Crazed is out in front of you.
Oh, yeah.
But that's because he's trying stuff where you're going, as soon as somebody come up with a whore thing, and that's what Crazed has done, well, you'd be a virgin now, right, Crazed?
I've had maybe like three whores, Remy. That was about it.
Same time?
No, all different times.
Nice. Sean, you're on Run FS.
Hey, Ronnie. Hey, Fez, I got a question for you. You said football was gay, but when Warren Sapp was in, you cried your eyes out. Did you think maybe he was going to be a Sapjacker that day or what? Uzi Poo on Twitter.
I was just thrilled to see a childhood hero.
You're older than him by a lot. Very weird.
Weird indeed.
Yeah, it's a weird day, isn't it, Crazed?
Yep.
I guess with the blackout, the internet blackout.
Yep.
Oh, this blackout's killing me.
Did you get your food yet, Crazed?
Nope.
Still getting hungry? You get a little lightheaded, right?
Nah, I'm good.
Crazed, based on my experience of hoping for food on this staff, I wouldn't hold your breath over this.
Crazed, you can have whatever you like. What would you like?
Just a nice vegan meal.
Oh, you would like our vegan dining option.
Yeah. Of course.
Nobody here really knows what that is.
What is it, bagel and cream cheese?
No, like, curry. I had a bagel, but I didn't have a cream cheese.
What'd you have it with, butter?
Nope, no butter.
What? Milk?
Just a dry bagel?
Just a dry bagel.
Oh,
and it was tasty.
No.
What do you want, hot dog?
Some
chicken?
I want a nice vegan meal.
I don't know what that is.
Meal? We don't know what to order you.
A bag of apples? Like what?
Have meat, fish, eggs, or dairy.
Hello, generic restaurant. May I please have a nice vegan meal? Thank you.
I'll have a non-vegan meal next to him. Vegan places in New York. And you guys don't know what
if you eat a nice vegan meal with another man, is that gay?
Nick, you're on Run FS.
That would be gay, yes.
Hey, Crazed. If I took you camping and you woke up the next day, fuck, I fucked it up.
Yeah, you didn't fuck it up.
What is he talking about?
Yeah, he had a fucking joke. He couldn't even pull it off. And it's a kid's joke. is a vegan meal air? Do you just fucking open your mouth and try to take in some air?
No.
You know what you ought to do? You ought to go out in the middle of a fucking herd of cattle. Start eating grass.
It just doesn't require anything from animal parts or dairy or anything that comes from an animal.
All right. Why don't you have an ice cream and squirrel?
Ice cream, good. Made out of
what
tofu.
Would it
good.
What is tofu squirrel, even no. fucking made out of?
It's I made out of soybeans.
What do you think fertilizes those beans?
I don't know. Plants.
What about soy sauce? I'll get you fucking Chinese.
Chinese is good.
Good.
Bean curd, vegetable bean curd.
Oh.
Did you say bean turd?
Bean curd.
You can't eat shit.
Are we playing a game we name the shittiest types of Chinese food?
Do you
think that animals have souls? Is that what it is?
Of course they do.
So you think people have souls?
Yes. Anything that's living has a soul.
So a plant has a soul.
Yes, but it's a lower functioning organism from an animal.
That's what I think a cheeseburger is. A lower functioning organism.
No, cows are actually very smart, Ronnie.
Compared to you, but
no,
to the rest
not
of
not
us.
Compared to me.
Do you think you lose a trivia question against a shrimp?
No.
If I had to fucking seriously, this is my what's keeping you out of work. If I'm fucking bringing somebody in, you and a cow.
Uh-huh.
Who should I pick to do the job?
You should pick me.
Yeah, all right, then I'm going to start milking you. Because the only thing I want to do is squeeze fucking milk out of a cow's tits.
Show us your nipples.
That's one of those gay laughs.
Yeah, no.
Here's Mark Kennedy, you're on Fez.
Hey, boys, how are you doing today? Did anybody else ever notice that when Fezzy talks about wanting a relationship before he has sex, he sounds exactly like Stalker Patty?
He and Stalker Patty have the same exact feelings about this. That crushed you down, Fez?
No, I just didn't realize I was sounding so nutty.
What? You're just expressing yourself. What do you want to... You're saying that you don't want to sound nutty, but your views are a little unusual, right?
Oh, yeah, from a lack of experience.
Well, they're not from a lack of experience as much as they are from a lack of desire. The reason why you got no experience is because you never had any desire.
Yeah, it was never an overwhelming desire to go out and have sex. That I had to have it.
It's not even that, but you didn't even have a whelming desire. Forget overwhelming. You didn't even have a whelming desire to have sex.
That's crazy.
Because it's not even that you did not go out and look for it. You've actually turned it down.
Yeah. Yeah, where it just, the thought of it made me so...
Disgusted?
Nervous.
But disgusted?
No, not really disgusted, I don't think, but just panicked.
What would be panicky about it? What would happen wrong? Sex is just one person shitting into another person's mouth. I don't want to...
Is that what it is?
Yes, well, you gotta do that.
I didn't know.
That's nasty.
What, sex?
No, shitting in someone else's mouth.
That's called a fucking soy bomb.
You're that's just nasty, Ronnie.
It's normal.
You got me, LT. I'll tell you this. I do like this fucking craze. Is this vegan, nice vegan meal almost here?
No, it hasn't been ordered yet.
Order him something nice. Nice vegan thing.
Get him a nice vegan meal. And you can't use the internet to find anything.
Oh, that's true.
Fuck,
you gotta use the yellow pages.
Bust out the yellow pages.
Okay,
come on.
Okay, there's nothing under vegan meal.
Let's go over here to Veronica. You're on Fez.
Hi, guys. I was just wondering if Fezzy masturbates.
That's really none of your business, though, is it, Veronica?
Well, you guys were on the topic, so just curious. I mean, he doesn't want to have an escort. Hasn't been in any relationships, so, like, how does he do it?
That's a good question. So you're actually thinking that we have the right to ask Fez these questions?
If Fez wants to answer.
You're a very rude young lady, too.
I'm not a rude lady.
What are you, Crazed?
I'm a man.
Is this meal
I'm a
here
manly
yet?
Man.
He's got these things up. He doesn't know how to use menus. Zeno doesn't know what's going on. He's all biking it up. He's fucking backstabbing.
Crazy. How does a vegetarian pita with avocado, tomato, sprouts, carrots, and lettuce with chipotle pepper spread sound?
That sounds delicious.
Can you get that with bacon?
Oh, yeah. Some turkey.
I'll see if I can add some bacon.
I don't need no bacon, no.
Ground beef.
I don't need no bacon. No. But that whole description sounded good. Zeets.
All right, I'll work on that for
you. Okay, thanks.
We'll get you that.
What do you want to drink? Like grass juice?
Carrot juice with beets.
Oh, my God.
Carrot juice with beets and...
Can you eat peanut butter?
Yeah.
Why don't you just have peanut butter and jelly every fucking meal?
Have something go vegan.
Edible.
That would get kind of tiring, though.
No, no. Wouldn't. Not compared to that dumb shit.
I don't know. That rap sounds fucking terrible. Fucking sprouts? Fuck that.
I don't know if I can get you
carrots. I'm putting good stuff in my body.
Just get him a fucking PB&J.
That's how I'm losing weight.
You want some sausage with it?
No.
I don't see carrot and beet juice on this paper with food on it.
Okay.
I don't know what this is.
How did you gain the weight in the first place, Crazed? If you've always been a vegan since childhood.
No, I've been a vegetarian most of my life.
Just eating a lot of cheese.
But I think it was the fact that I just ate a lot and I buried my feelings.
Oh, I know.
What are your feelings? I didn't really,
express yourself. What are your feelings? Anger?
Anger, depression.
What are you sad about?
Sadness.
What are you sad about, buddy?
Crazy?
Well, a lot of the time I just realized that, I was upset because I didn't learn as fast as other people, people always looked at me differently or whatever.
Crazed. Listen to me. The only thing that kept you from learning was black guys smacking you in the back of your head. So you'd have some fucking decent grades right now.
Bullying.
Do you ever get an A in anything?
I got A's, yeah.
What'd you get A in?
English.
You're really good at English, huh?
Nice. I'm okay. My spelling is atrocious, though.
Mm.
It's really bad.
It's just a bunch of fucking letters just fucking put all over the place.
No. I try to sound out the words, but usually in English...
This is what he was doing in spelling test. He tried to draw pictures of what they were saying.
Usually in English, it's just like,
You know what you'd be good at? You're like being an Egyptian, just fucking drawing out fucking pictures of shit.
Usually in English, it words sound some way, but they look different from where the
I understand.
They
sound. You know why? It's the lack of meat. You get some fucking meat, you start spelling like a fucking champ.
Nah,
you're like one of those Asian kids down there.
Get that brain.
Could
sharp.
You use that in a sentence, please?
Use what in a sentence?
I was doing a spelling test, something you've never been fucking involved in.
Yeah, I have.
Josh, you're on Run of Fez.
Do you think that Craze could maybe be Fez's life coach? Because Craze sounds like he's in the pocket. He's fucking talking smooth. He's making sense. I love it, Craze. Keep it up.
Thanks, my brother.
Now, Fez, do you feel like Craze is further along in you than in most things?
Definitely in sex and relationships.
And he has friends?
Yeah, he's very social, too, yes.
He goes out. Where are you lacking at stuff, Patty? What's your big lack right now? You're on that bowling team, right?
No.
That's trivia.
That's not me, that's
By the
Patty.
Way, Brazilian Julie is trying to fucking use me to get to an English
You know what I think? Honestly,
really?
Yeah. I think Fez should go out with Stalker Patty. That would be perfect.
Whoa!
Yeah! You're trying to be a matchmaker.
I think black guys should come by and smack him in the back of the head when he's trying to do the show.
Hey, Sway, get in here.
Oh, man. Every time I hear that, I think of that Stone song now, and I start fucking going, damn, I wish we were playing that. Fezzy, what's going to be for you to find the Crazed in yourself? To take the fucking chances the Crazed takes?
I guess getting over the panic. Crazed doesn't seem to panic. He seems to fight his fears.
No, please, don't even start. I'll throw the rest of the show away. Seriously, I'll be just like, listen to this, Crazed.
Stone's one thing.
I can't fucking help.
I mean, I panic sometimes, of course, but like for instance, like if I drop something on the floor, I'm like, oh, what the fuck? And I'm like, how the fuck am I going to clean this up?
No.
Yeah.
All right, so let's fucking throw his vegan meal on the floor.
Yeah.
No, that wouldn't be great.
Do you remember what he ate last time? It's like he did throw it on the floor.
Oh, whoa, man. Why you gotta take shots at Sea Dog?
What are you talking about?
Punch him right in his fucking back. He just had an operation, Chris.
Yeah, aim for the back.
I'll punch him right in his cranium.
All right, Pittsburgh, you're on a Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, Craze. I'm grabbing on to this whole life coach thing. I think it's a great idea. And Craze, I'd like to see you talk Fez into but there's no anxiety of him getting a blowjob from a guy or a girl.
If that's what he wants to do, that's his business.
Do you have anxiety about receiving oral sex?
Yes.
What?
Yeah.
Fuck that.
What are you anxious about?
That, like,
feels great.
That I won't respond to it.
So your anxiety means that you're not turned on by such a thing.
No, not that I wouldn't be turned on, that I just wouldn't perform.
If there's no performance that you have to do when receiving head.
Yeah, it's just like biology or whatever.
You just sit there. The girl gets in between your legs.
Oh, you just turned them
or
off.
Or the guy or whatever.
But
I mean, a guy for him.
Oh!
Not for me.
I don't know. You've had all kinds of different experiences, Craze.
I had chicks. Strictly chicks.
With dicks.
Suck my dick.
Oh.
Strictly chicks suck my dick.
Do your parents know that you've been with prostitutes?
I don't know if they have.
Did they ever ask you about it?
Nope.
They old like vegan hippies?
They're vegetarian.
Yeah.
I'm the only one that's
But are they
vegan.
Hippies?
They're hippies, though.
Yeah?
They're kind of hippies.
You got any brothers and sisters?
Nope. I'm the only person.
That's crazy.
They stopped when they saw me.
Where'd they meet each other? Woodstock?
Nope. They met each other for friends.
Oh.
Yep.
Like Dead concert?
I don't know. It's
what'd your dad do? Make belts?
Nope. My father.
Saltwater.
My father is retired, but he basically was a software. He worked with people with software, and he basically managed and groups and.
Sorry
stuff.
If you don't understand,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Still, like LimeWire.
All this time. Still don't know what your dad did. Yeah.
No.
I understand. No, he managed software.
No, I understand it. It's just hard for me to explain. He like basically was a manager, and he managed other people that were below him and basically made sure everything ran the way it should have ran.
That's great. Why don't you try to bring that up in your group, that you're a pedigree. That's the kind of job you should be having.
A pedigree? That's like a dog, Ronnie.
No, it's not, but okay.
Isn't it a pedigree, like a dog or something?
I mean, it can be, but, you know, you also, humans have pedigree.
Uh-huh.
It's also a type of non-vegan dog.
I mean, you're the one
food.
Saying that you have a soul like a fucking animal.
Eat an animal, Grace.
Were you really happy without Zito the last couple of days?
I think it went a lot smoother for me.
You've been on the air more today, though.
Mm.
Fez, if Ronnie got like a really hot chick to suck your dick right on the Ronnie show.
Thank God this is an XL.
Don't ruin the surprise.
Would you go for it?
I'll tell you this. If he says yes, I'll get you a hot prostitute for each of you. Would you be in Crazed?
Yeah.
Fez?
No.
Oh.
Okay. Oh, well.
No, it's got to be two together.
Yeah, I
put you guys in a limo.
Hell yeah!
It's a fucking night out in the town. You're partying.
Yeah, but
I get the alcohol,
no.
I get the weed.
He ruined it. Oh well.
Maybe Crazed didn't want it either.
He's kind of letting go pretty quickly.
No, because I have a chick, you know, and I don't want to go that route.
Oh yeah, because her friend that goes out on dates with you might say something.
If he shows up again, I might just knock him the fuck out.
No, I like the attitude, dude. I like what you fucking call you getting fucking street now.
Yep.
Baller.
Because I'm crazed from the streets. Crazed from the streets, yo. Crazed from the streets. Crazed from the streets, yo.
It was almost the start of something, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Sort of.
One thing about fucking Crazed, he's always ready to throw the rhymes down.
Yep.
He's a lyricist above everything else.
Yeah, no doubt.
Joe, you're on Run of Fez.
Pretty cool.
Hey, let's just go back to the fact that Crazed said he's good at English, but he is not good at spelling. I mean, isn't that basically like saying I'm a good musician, but I can't play notes?
You said something. You're very good at English, but you said you have no idea what a verb is, and you've never used...
A verb basically describes something.
It's not.
A person, place, or thing.
That's a verb?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, that's a noun. A noun is to describe something.
We're going to move along in our lesson.
Okay.
Why would a noun describe something?
Never mind. I'm fucking retarded.
Don't put yourself
down. Don't even say that. I mean, clinically you're not, are you, Crazed?
No, no.
What did they say? What did they...
I'm learning disabled.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, I don't know. I sometimes forget things that I was taught in school.
I like to say that you're learning discapable.
Okay. Well, I am able to learn.
Right.
So I'm not learning discapable.
Should you have a helmet on right now?
No, because I don't have seizures.
Do you have any soft spots that didn't fucking harden up?
No.
When's the last time someone checked?
I don't know. I mean,
Crazy.
I mean, I have a perfect skull here.
Okay. You do. It is fucking perfect. A couple chicks brought that up.
Yeah.
So you said you would
they
be...
They like to kiss me on my dome.
Right. You would be with a chick. You would be with Brazilian Julie if she wanted to.
Yeah, probably.
All right.
But
you're saying probably. Like, but if she did, you would go for her.
Yeah, I would.
You would turn your back on this fucking...
No. That she wants to be with you. If I was single, Ronnie.
But she wants to be with you tonight.
Nah, I couldn't do that this girl.
That's gay.
No, it isn't. It's not gay.
This girl stood you up on your second date.
Okay. Forget all that. I think that if you can't hurt a girl's feelings, I think that's gay.
How is that gay?
Yeah, we got some vegan food for you.
Woohoo!
There you go, a nice vegan meal.
All right, let's take a look at it. You got napkins with it. Where'd it come in from?
Came in from Metro Cafe downstairs. All right. We had this thing called the menu back there that I used.
All right, take a bite.
Thanks.
Take a bite and tell us what you think.
How you like that, Crazed?
Let's see what goes. Let's see what how it goes.
Yeah, rap while you eat.
He's a rapping eater.
It's wrapped up in this nice wrapping paper.
Yeah,
and I'm gonna eat with the stayer.
Now, could any of that would that do anything for you?
I would throw that in someone's face. Right? Like
it this. Certainly doesn't seem like food.
It's
now take a bite. And somewhere in there, there's meat. We're not telling you where.
There's
yummy.
You just ate some meat in there.
No, there isn't.
Yeah, there's a little piece of meat that we're hiding.
Yeah, we got you didn't get it.
No, there isn't. There's hummus and carrots, lettuce.
Ryan, you're in Red Fez.
There's no meat in there.
Hey, Chris got an A in autism, didn't you? I got the ones and twos on your left and right cheek.
Go fuck yourself.
I will.
Here's Lab in Canada.
I got a couple things there for Craze. Craze, have you ever been around a cow before?
No.
They're the most retarded fucking animals on Earth, first of all. Second of all, you eat vegetables, right?
Yeah.
Do you know what your vegetables are mostly fertilized with?
Yeah, well, I usually get, like, organic vegetables.
Those aren't.
You spend a few extra bucks, eh, for the organic,
Yeah.
Well, why did you do that, Christ?
I don't know.
Why did you just make that sound?
I made a cow noise because I'm hearing cow noise.
I heard wrong.
I heard me out.
A lot of people are fucking angry from earlier when you were chomping down on stuff that isn't food.
That thing's getting devoured.
You're eating your fucking own yard when you're eating that shit.
And as I said, it is getting... You're putting it on the floor.
No, I'm putting it in my hand.
Those vegan sandwiches just don't stick together very well.
Ugh. Why would they? They don't have anything holding them together. It's fucking good. It's
the vegetable aisle throwing around a fucking tortilla.
It's delicious.
So the vegans live longer, or does it just fucking feel that way?
They live longer.
Who wants to, though?
If you eat vegan... It'll put more like 5 years on your life.
Great. From fucking 87 to 92. So you get the fucking shit in a pamper and call your fucking nurse mommy.
My grandmother is still living and she's 101.
Is that right?
Yep.
What's she think of you?
She loves me.
I bet she does, buddy. I bet she's crazy about you. Crazy is a good dude. I'm going to say this. Probably right now he's my best friend.
Ever?
Excellent. Yeah.
I've known Crazy for a few years. How long have we known each other? Like 5 years now?
At least.
Yeah.
We're homies.
Crazed. How's the moo go? How's the cow go?
There's no cow in there.
No, do your cow fucking voice. Like. And a sheep? Sheep? Giraffe?
I don't know what the fuck a giraffe sounds like.
Do a rhino. Lion? Squirrel? This is great. It's like it. For his parents, it must be like if your baby never grows up, you can just fucking have fun playing with it forever. Because I remember, like, when. I remember being so fucking little that people would get impressed if you would just do something like that.
Well, like, fucking with the kids, have them do shit.
Yeah, but, like, don't you being, like, remember being a little kid and doing, like, the simplest thing and everybody being happy about
it?
Yay! Hey, look at you.
You said
fucking
water.
Standing up.
This is a great sandwich.
Yeah, enjoy. That's all for you. You want something after? You want, like, a little dessert? What do you like?
Egg sandwich? A vegan cupcake.
Yeah, across the street. Magnolia has them. Get him a nice one from Magnolia. Crazy, do you remember your first memory?
Yeah, I was, like, around four, and my father... Well, even further than that, I remember running around on this one of those like scooter things that a kid could sit in, and they have like these little trays where you could eat and have like your toys and stuff like that, and you just could run around the whole thing. And I would love that thing, and I would just scoot around in it and like lift my legs up and like. Slide all over the place.
This when you were in high school?
No, this was like when I was like two or three. And then another memory was when I was like around four years old. My father took me like to on this big boat.
See a specialist?
No, we took on this big boat and we watched films about boats and like and like we would fly
Hold
kites.
On. Let's stop it. Why would you get on a boat and then watch a film about a boat? That's fucking stupid.
I don't know. Ask him, but it was fun.
Why was fun? I'm going to take you on a boat and then we're going to watch a film about being on a boat.
Nothing.
Why don't we just fucking pay attention to the boat?
We're on a boat.
Yeah,
exactly.
We're on a boat now. Why do I want to watch one?
I can learn in real time from people operating the boat right now.
I'm going to take you out on this fishing boat. Watch this thing about people fishing in a movie. Well, you lived out on Long Island, right? So you must have been surrounded by boats,
right?
No,
it was in Queens.
Yeah, same thing.
Yeah.
Crazed as a kid. Would you please bring in some fucking kid pictures the next time you come in?
Yeah. You mind if I take your tissue?
Okay, help yourself. We just have them for when Fez starts crying. He's having a good day today. That's it. Blow your nose in the fucking microphone. What are you going to do?
Oh,
what are you going to do? Blow your nose after every vegan sandwich?
Nope.
What is that, a vegan meal? Ugh. Fucking cucumbers coming through your nostrils?
Yep.
Crazed, I'm going to take you to a restaurant and show you a movie about a restaurant.
Here's Food Inc. You're not going to get any food.
And then later, some black guys are going to come by, smack you in the back of the head, and call you Looney Tooney. Don't hurry, I want your vegan cupcakes to get here. What are you getting, a dozen?
No. One is good.
I never even ate a vegan cupcake before, have you?
Fuck no. I dated a girl that was vegetarian. I ate like vegetarian salami. It was terrible.
That's fucking, that doesn't even make sense.
It's a soy salami.
But a vegan cupcake doesn't have any egg in it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sounds terrible.
I bet it tastes exactly like this. He's just.
Jesus
Christ. It's like mowed the lawn in here.
No, it's the bottom of the monkey cage is what it fucking looks like.
I always make a fucking mess when I eat.
Look at you.
I'm a messy eater.
You ever think about being in fucking film or anything?
Sure. I always talk to Franklin. I'm like,
I know.
Hey, Franklin, why don't you have me as an extra?
He said, dude, no, forget that. I was talking to him the other day, and he's doing a movie. I'm not even kidding. I think you'd be perfect for it.
What movie is that?
It's the part of Senator Palin's kid. And you would just being yourself, just fucking traveling
I'm
around
doing
shit.
I'm not a retard.
No,
I'm not Down syndrome.
No, but you're playing one in a fucking movie.
You're an actor, Crazed.
Yeah.
Thespian.
He's not a lesbian either.
Oh.
Here's Bob. Bob, you're on first.
Thanks, Ronnie. Yeah. Hey, I think it's ironic that Porky Pig is a vegan. No, any man that orders bean sprouts for another man is gay.
Oh! Well,
Porky Pig would be a vegan because it would be cannibalism. Even though I know you're referring to Chris.
So you don't want to be in Franklin's movie? Should I tell him no?
I don't think... he didn't offer it to me, so...
Mm. You should be in it.
Nah, I'm not going to do retard, no.
Never go full retard.
No.
I'll tell you, Fezzy, he's in this today. He's in the moment today. You've got the wall up today, though, right? You're behind the wall.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm trying to stay focused.
I think that you did good until this fucking Hicks interrupted you today and made you seem like your shit was fucking crazy. It was no crazier than fucking Zeet stuff, and fucking Hicks threw himself into that like it was a fucking pool.
What's the matter, Fez? You look like you're bumming.
I'm fine. I'm just having a little panic day.
Talk to C, man. Tell him what's going on. He's trying to fucking... He's reaching out to you and you're pushing him away.
I have panic attacks, Craze, and I'm having a rough one today.
Mm-hmm. You having one right now?
Yep. No. I mean, I can feel it coming on,
but... Am I making you nervous?
No. Now that stand the sandwich gone.
If you stand closer to him and make funny faces.
Closer, Craze.
All right, this is really weird.
All right, that's kind of weirded me out.
That's weirded me out, too.
Because that's a really close... Silly, crazy face.
Maybe it'll be helpful if you tell the funniest story you can and we'll judge you on it. Ready? Go. 3, 2, 1. All right, nothing happened there, Craze. What?
The funniest story I could... Oh, okay. Well, there was this one day I went into a cigar shop. And... And I asked, did they have a telephone? And they didn't really have a telephone. So then I basically said, screw you. And then I walked out. This would happen like 5 years ago. And then took the train and I went down to the city to go to the Bar 9 for Fezzy W's birthday. His big 47th birthday.
What?
We had drinks. And then I came out and to see if anybody was smoking some weed or whatever. And then I bump into Ronnie B and he was smoking a cigar. And what was across from Ronnie B was the telephone booth. How freaky is that?
That's good.
That's fucking nuts.
Now, here's the thing, Fez. He went and told your story.
Mm-hmm.
You're freezing. He's taking a run with it. All right, we got to... And by the way, somebody wrote to me and said that vegan cupcakes are all Crisco. This is like eating straight Crisco.
Ugh. I'm actually having a hard time finding vegan cupcakes close by.
Magnolia.
No. All their cupcakes have butter in them, is what we were told.
Butter is fucking vegan.
Doesn't it come from cow?
Yeah, it does.
They have non-fucking buttery cows. All right, we're going to break
here. Great lunch, by the way, Zeets.
But don't worry, you got dessert coming your way, too. Is it in yet, Zeets?
We're working on it.
You better hurry up. We got a break. We'll be right back. Crazed is in here. And Crazed, you had something you wanted to talk about, right? You had a topic on your mind.
Not really.
Okay. So we'll get to that as soon as we get back. It's a blackout. Nope. Fuck Sopa. Fuck Pippa. Fucking day.
Go to hell. forever.
Stay off the internet.
Fuck it. Show them that you fucking care about this.
And don't go into the nice mall. We'll be right back. It's the Ron and Fez Show.
What's up, buddies?
It's Fez in here with me. How are you, Fezzy? Did you lock up?
I said what?
He's not talking to me, is he?
Okay.
What do you think is going on with Fez today, Craze? You were talking to him during a commercial break a little bit.
I asked him what's wrong, and he said he had he's having these like high anxiety attacks.
You up too high, Fez?
Well, I'm it's 36th floor, but it's an anxiety attack nonetheless.
But do you feel like it's high anxiety, like from being heights?
It may have something to do with it. It certainly doesn't help.
Why don't you pop a Zanny?
I don't have a Zanny to pop.
You want one?
I would take one at this point.
Like a Vicodin, maybe, from Zeets.
That's all you need, buddy. Someone wrote to me and said that those things are not all Crisco. What, you don't even know what's in a vegan cupcake. Fez, you got your list of new friends?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about each one?
Well, they were just people that joined me on the Intero Bang on the NFL playoff wire.
Do you realize how many times you're going to have to fucking pay up for this? You're not supposed to mention the internet today.
Oh, sorry.
Where's those court? There's a quarter.
Who are the names?
Stapleton 69.
What's going on there?
Just someone who meets me someplace that I'm not talking about today.
Yeah, I know, but you don't tell us about that person, their personality. What's going on? What makes them friends? Who else have you met?
Chris Brown.
Okay, the singer. Great. Who else?
Punchy.
What's the story with Punchy?
Little, kind of punchy, actually.
In what way?
Kind of, curtain to the point when making comments.
Like, give us an example.
Really quick to bash a team that he doesn't like.
What team
or
did
she,
he,
I don't know.
What team did he or she bash? I don't feel like you're really making friends with these people. Like, what team?
A lot of them I just met.
What team did Punchy like? What team didn't Punchy like?
Punchy liked the Giants, I think.
Punchy's in a good mood.
Why are you shaking your head no, though?
Because I don't know if that's true or not.
Then why are you saying it? Why don't you say I don't know who any of these people are? So when you go to the room, you don't exactly interact.
No, we all interact, but I haven't, you know, we talk about what the topic is. I haven't gotten into anyone's personal life yet.
Or where they're from or what's going on.
No, none of that.
Does that surprise you? You're a longtime internet person.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think Fez just kind of like, what's the matter?
Your mic needs to be potted up.
Can anybody hear me now?
I've heard you the whole time.
Okay. All right. What I was saying.
Fez, you're really getting pissed off?
No, it's just I keep fixing the mic and I got it as close as I could. I needed it potted up and I got told no.
Why wouldn't you?
I thought that was the signal to drop the music, because I thought the music was too hot. I thought
no, I went up.
Oh,
you want more music?
No.
Well, we don't know what you're saying with these things, but I know that you're upset.
This tune reminds me of the Wonder Years.
I shouldn't have mentioned it.
Why shouldn't you have mentioned it? You're allowed to say that people won't listen to you.
I just needed him potted up more.
That's nothing's wrong with that.
Everything cool?
Yeah.
All right, so this is your vegan cupcakes.
Woohoo. Now,
how do we know that they're vegan?
Well, if they're vegan, they're vegan.
I don't think that these are vegan.
How do you know?
Because of that place they got them from?
Yeah.
What if you had something that's non-vegan? It wouldn't be good for you, right?
I'm going to try it anyway. They said it was vegan, so.
All right. All right. Give it a try.
Mm-hmm.
Treat yourself.
Yeah.
Will you be able to tell one bite into it?
Probably not.
But so you don't care, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
You're just going to enjoy yourself.
How's that cupcake, Chris?
This is definitely a vegan cupcake.
100%.
And it tastes delicious.
I'm glad you're liking it.
And, it's yummy.
Isn't that bad, like, for diabetes and stuff, to, like, eat a cup?
It is, but I'm going to probably take an insulin shot when I get home.
Okay. I just want to make sure you're safe.
Yeah.
All right, Punchy said, we went to the Golden Globes without Fez, and we had just as much fun. Is that true, Fez?
I showed up eventually in the Golden Globes, and it was a lot of fun.
You're on your second vegan cupcake?
Yep.
Jesus. How many vegan cupcakes do you think you can eat?
I don't know.
Did you eat 30?
No. I'm going to probably eat the second one, and that's it.
That's it?
Yeah, that's all I need.
Two nice cupcakes, and that's it.
Great. Yeah. To be fair, there are only two cupcakes, so...
Yeah.
Careful with that frosting. Yeah.
It's vegan frosting.
No, it'll stain your clothing.
Okay.
I punch you, wrote something back in. You don't even want to hear it, TFS.
No.
Oh, shit.
Punches. No, I was being nice. I was complimenting Punchy.
What did he
say? I was saying Punchy was one of the nice people we met in the room.
You said
wasn't nothing but complaints.
You says wasn't funny. We can pull the tape when you said wasn't funny. You said curt and not funny. That's what I guess set he or she off.
Crazy, did you get the frosting on your clothes?
A little bit, yeah. Unfortunately.
Hicks told you to watch out for that.
Mm-hmm.
Crazy, I want to fucking put a barber apron on you when you're eating.
Yeah.
I'm a fucking slop.
Oh, don't put yourself down.
Yeah, don't say that.
You make a black guy want to smack you in the back of the head when you start to down talk yourself.
And you know what can happen.
Mm-hmm. All right, Punchy keeps keeping the internet fucking battle going.
Jesus, Punch.
Punchy doesn't respect the dark internet today.
No. Well, I think you can send emails, can't you?
Yeah, I mean...
You just can't go to websites.
Yeah,
so,
Boo websites.
So what's wrong with the internet?
Well, apparently there's a lot of pedophiles on there.
Of course.
You on the internet, right?
Yeah, but I don't go near, kids.
But you like porn, right?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, there's some crossover there.
Yeah, sometimes you don't even know it.
Mm-hmm. I can tell, though.
Would you get an underage prostitute?
No.
What if it was really cheap?
What's the perfect age prostitute for you? 60?
No.
What's perfect age?
I don't know. 18 to 21.
You're really coming close to that line, ain't you, brother?
18 to 21, probably, yeah.
You can tell if they're between 17 and 18-year-old. You'll know the difference?
Probably not.
You'd be willing to take that chance, though.
No, but I mean, if you get them from a legit service,
yeah,
they're probably going to be,
Why don't you do this? Isn't your thing that you make her sit on a curb, and if her knees hit the street, don't look at you. You just you're eating like you fucking don't have any teeth. I think your teeth are too far set back.
But he does use those above the board.
They're not doing a chomping that you need.
Oh boy.
What do you just have? That's fucking Fez's line.
That's not my fucking day.
What's wrong? You just have back teeth?
No, I have teeth.
Any front ones?
Yeah.
There they are.
Yeah. Using the bite with.
Yeah. Close the mouth.
Like you're eating plankton over there. They're fucking. Oh, Idol's back?
Yeah.
They give him back this year?
I'm sure they will be. I'm sure they'll be buying some mosquito nets and chalkboards.
Tonight, I hope that they have somebody who thinks they can sing, but they can't. And then we could all laugh at them like, that fucking retarded person can't sing.
Oh, no, that's kind of mean.
Or they're nerdy and they want to be a star? Mm-hmm. Never.
Their voice sounds like shit.
Then we can feel real superior to them.
Hey, when they eliminate them by having Randy Jackson walk up behind them and slap them in the head.
We can feel intellectually and economically superior to that person. You want to get any more cupcakes?
No, I'm good.
Send an intern.
Do you want any vegan licorice?
I'd like,
Do you eat vegan candy?
I'd like a bottle of water. That's about it.
Black water?
I mean, get you black water.
What's black water?
All black water. It's water with meat. It's kind of gravy, I guess.
No, I just want a bottle of water. If you can do that, that'd be great. And other than that, I'm good. I'm good. Thank you.
All right, grab a mic over here. I haven't had you on all day today. You see, everybody, it's become a struggle.
Yeah.
Were you in talking with Fez on the entire bang the other day?
I made one comment.
What was your comment?
That I was, I had simulated the Broncos Patriots game on my Nintendo 64 using Quarterback Club 98. And the results were that the Broncos were going to crush the Patriots.
Well, because you still had Elway.
That's true. And I didn't think about that when I ran it. They haven't updated the rosters for the game. They don't really support it anymore. So it was a little off.
Yeah.
So
what's going on in your head today? What's happening in Fredhead?
Well, I've been thinking about some things recently.
Sure.
Got some more.
This is the place. By the way, do you know Crazed?
Yeah.
Good.
We met a few times.
Cool.
Yeah, we met a few times today.
You know, he does improv. Have you ever done any improv before?
Yeah, I have. Great. I'm not that good at it, but I've tried.
Could you, you guys want to do an improv right now?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Yeah, all right, sure.
All right, you're a cab driver.
Okay.
And Crazed, you want to go to the hospital because you're holding a stillborn baby. And go.
I really need to get to the hospital fast now. I really need to get to the hospital.
Sir, is that a stillborn baby in your lap?
Yeah.
I think it's too late for that baby.
Yeah, but I need to get to the hospital. I need to dispose of this baby quickly.
Sir, I think it'd be much cheaper if I just take you to a dumpster.
Yeah, but I really need to get to the hospital quickly.
All right, can I just break you guys here? You haven't taken the scene anywhere. We're still in this place with the stillborn baby. Some action has to take place. All right, I want you to try the same thing, but you're both Chinese, and go.
I really need to go and get the stillborn baby and go to the hospital.
Sir, you have stillborn baby in my car. Smell like baby.
All right, I want you to just stop for a second. First of all, you're both racist. And second of all, Chinese doesn't mean retarded.
Chinese is smart and intelligent. What are you talking about?
All right, I want us to... called China, anywhere in China right now.
And me poo poo on your poo poo.
All right, I want to see if we can we can make them believe the Crazed is Chinese. Let's go over here to Chris Brown. Hold on, I think Crazed fell asleep.
No, I'm awake.
Oh, I heard you snoring.
No, I'm awake.
Sometimes you snore when you're awake?
No. I might breathe a little bit heavy, but I'm all right.
That's okay.
What do you think, Crazed? What's your opinion? You're a man of, you know.
Okay, what are you asking me?
I'm asking.
He hasn't
you,
been paying attention. You've been asleep.
No, I have been.
You ate some food. You wanted to take a nap. That's what just happened.
Like a fucking vegan dinosaur.
No, I. No, you're talking about women and should you stay with them if you're done with them or afterwards.
What would you do, Craze? Because you know a thing or two about women. It,
depending on the situation, okay? If I see that there possibly might be a friendship afterwards.
Mm.
If the relationship is not sabotaged or wrecked, you know? But it's because sometimes relationships end because they're like, we're better off as friends, you know, or whatever.
Not, whatever you're talking about has nothing to do with this.
Yes,
this was a romantic fucking relationship they do that. You guys broke up why?
For a myriad of reasons. I mean, we were living together.
You
and
hear
it, her? That, hmm? No, wait. Did you ask if I beat her?
That's one reason to break up. What's up?
Eat her. Did you eat her?
I mean, occasionally, but.
Sure.
Oh, yeah.
And ass too?
No. Never the ass. No,
that's why you probably don't want to go back.
Yeah, maybe.
So, who called? Who reached out? Who called first? Or did you do that fucking bullshit online stuff?
No, I reached out to her. And I felt weird because I didn't want to just reach out and be like, oh, hey, I'm ready to get back together. I wanted.
Did
to
you see- say, I miss your beef? I miss your fucking beef?
Not in those exact words, but in
where
a way.
Where the pussy at?
Come on, don't laugh at him. He's a fucking guy.
No,
come
on, I'm not laughing.
This is like a real. Yeah. I'm trying to be real and open myself up here
on
the air.
No, I'm not laughing at you. I'm just laughing at Pep.
But the thing, it's coming off like you're laughing in his fucking face.
No, you're laughing
I mean,
at
he's
my...
got his fucking. I mean, is it coming off sounding like a little gay to you that his heart's open?
No.
But why can't we just be guys and be honest with you?
Doesn't have to be constant. They're sensitive guys, okay? And then there's not so sensitive guys, and then there's just gay.
Right.
So, which right, one
so that's what you think he's coming off as?
No, he's no. Obviously, if he wants to try to get back with this girl, then he's a sensitive guy.
So does that
guy.
Make you mad?
Well, yeah,
you're
I
angry,
guess.
Right? Sure, you have every right to be.
Yeah, Craig said gay guys aren't sensitive.
Well, here's the thing. No, he says it even more. He's sounding like there's two. He's like, this guy is sensitive. At least he's not. Is where he's coming from.
No, he's not gay, but he's sensitive.
Right.
That's what I'm
Don't
saying.
Don't you think of yourself as a sensitive guy?
Yeah, I'm definitely a sensitive guy.
All right, let's get back to what you were saying.
Yeah.
Well, do you want a long-distance relationship, or you want to get back together with her?
That's another thing. I've always hated long-distance relationships, but I would want one with this person.
Yeah, you'd rather. Long-distance is even better.
Yes, you can fuck around all you want. She thinks...
No, but it keeps fucking things going good.
Yeah, because then you're not seeing this person all the time. You're not, you know...
You kind of hate him even though you love her.
Will you mind, has she been with a lot of other guys?
I don't think she's been with a lot, but it doesn't really bother me. Like
you actually even like it. You like to see her with another dude.
A little bit.
Yeah. There's a lot of fucking dudes into that. They're like, go ahead. You like fucking my chick?
Nothing wrong with that, I guess.
I guess if that's your scene, you're a fucking cuckold. I mean, fucking Crazed takes other fucking dudes out on dates with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a whole other level.
Well, the guy just shows up,
right.
you know, and a girl...
But he stayed.
The girl says... I'm taking this guy with us because I'm nervous and I don't know you that well.
Didn't you guys all meet in the same group?
Yeah.
At the same time?
Yeah.
Huh. I didn't know it was a group thing.
Yeah.
So you know
I stated that.
Oh, I wasn't picking up on that. I thought maybe it was like a brother or...
No, we all met at the same same group.
This other guy in the group, was it Meatloaf?
No.
Was it that
don't even out? Start on that. All right, let's get back to your thing right now. Fred, it seems like you're bringing this up because you want us to say yes.
No, I'm asking I'm just asking advice.
But here's the thing. What is it about New York girls that turn you off that you don't want?
I don't know what it is. I've just never been able to, like, really... connect with somebody.
Is it
I guess.
Their attitude?
Yeah, I think it's the attitude.
They're all whores to you.
Kind of.
They all fashionistas?
Yeah, they're kind of really more.
Well, you don't like playing the field. That fucking fucks you up a little bit.
I get. I've been trying to, but it's not working out. So I just didn't want to feel like, oh well, I tried this for a little bit. I'm giving up. I just didn't want to feel like I've given up on it. I wanted to make sure that this is something that I really wanted.
Have you ever painted this girl?
Now, the guys in your group,
yes.
Right? Was it Cheswick?
No.
Martini?
No.
But you see where I'm going with this, right?
Well, they're all drinks.
Yeah, okay, but I'm saying,
so
you guys are on a group together, right?
Yeah.
And you're getting, did Turkle go out and get you booze?
No.
All right, so it's you... Martini, Cheswick, and you
and
guys
schnapps.
But you guys listen to Dr. Spivey, right? I mean, everybody's paying attention.
Yeah.
What about Chief? Was he there?
Chief?
Bencini?
No.
You ever talk to Chief? You get him to...
Nah.
No.
What about Tabor? Was he in your fucking group?
No.
Was everybody together?
No, no, she just brought this other guy.
Now, hold on. This is for Fred now. Jonathan, go ahead.
Hey, buddy, it's Freddie. I said go for it, dude. I broke up with my now wife for about 7 months. I mean, we got back together, got married, bought a house, and got a kid on the way. It's a beautiful thing, man. Go for it.
See?
All right.
It fucking happens for some people. I don't like these people when they have their absolutes. You know the fucking difference.
That's why I thought I was one of those person that thought the absolutes were right, but now I'm thinking maybe they're not. Maybe I'm learning something about life.
Do you have a coin with you right now?
I honestly think
who's got a coin?
That he should.
I have a coin.
This
you
is an
really
unlucky coin.
Love this girl.
Yeah.
Here's the thing.
All right.
Heads, you get back together with her. Right. Tails, you don't. Now, this is an old fucking trick.
All right.
When you flip that in the air,
yeah,
you're gonna know which side you hope it lands on. Okay. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're gonna know, and that's the one that you go with.
All right.
When that was in the air, what did you want it to be?
Heads.
You wanted to be with her.
Yeah.
Why care? I mean, let's see. And it came out heads.
It did.
So here's the thing. You know you can break up with this bitch anytime you want. You've already done it.
Okay, up until
you know, for a year you didn't give a fuck.
Up until you said that last part, that was like a great little scene in a romantic comedy. I thought it was great. It's like the guy giving like, dude, you know what you gotta do. Just go
you
get
know.
It.
You know. Everybody knows in their fucking heart what they really want. Then they play with all these fucking details like they don't. Now here's the thing. If you go back to her, then this is expected to be permanent.
That's that was the scary thing I was thinking about. Once you do this again, it's going to be super weird if it breaks off again. Like, it's going to be even worse than the first time. Like, it's pretty much for good.
Forever.
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 And that's kind of scary. I mean, if it's not going to work out, it's not going to work out. So, I don't know.
How old are you, Fred?
28.
28. Okay. Well, Here's what I think, you know? I think that you should try getting back with this girl, you know? See, but take it slowly.
Okay.
Well,
take it slow.
Fucking Jimi Hendrix was dead when he was this kid's age. It was already over for him.
Yeah, but he was on drugs.
There's so is Fred.
Fred is fucking wired.
Then he is.
I mean, he was like... Jimi Hendrix was doing, like, acid and
so is
shit.
Fred.
Mm-hmm.
We all do acid.
Mm-hmm.
It's in our fucking cupcakes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm starting to trip already.
You went through those fucking cupcakes like they were fucking vegan air pollen.
Yep.
Fez, you seem like you're still pissed off at fucking Punchy.
Well, I just don't see why you have to... When something was really nice and fun and everybody seemed to have a good time, why you gotta try to ruin it? Why you gotta rain on it?
I thought we already came back to a spot. And we're gonna fix your thing. You're gonna start interacting with people.
Oh, yeah. Every comment will be directed at Punchy.
Get back together with Punchy.
Well, I feel like he's trying to make it work. Yeah, Punchy could be that person for you.
So what exactly is interrobang.com? I hear it messaged.
Well, why don't you just fucking dial it in once instead of asking?
Oh, okay.
It'd be that fucking easy for you. Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be a mystery.
That's the interrobang. The interrobang. The interrobang. That's all I hear.
That happened a long time ago. That was only the day it came out.
Yeah, we can play that forever.
I know. Crazed has no sense of time. I mean, to him right now, it feels like the Big Bang was fucking yesterday.
I still hit him on the head.
I think you're going to find work, Cheswick. I do. Why don't you take your group and you all go out on a fucking deep sea fishing trip together?
Therapeutic.
Yeah, fight over who gets to fucking drive the boat.
I just want to spend time with... I want to just spend the time with this chick alone, get to know her.
How quick before you try to get it in? First night?
It depends, you know. And we already had our first date. It didn't happen, you know.
Right.
So
that's all right. She's DTF, huh?
She says she's DTF, but yeah,
okay. She says I'm down to fuck,
but she isn't.
She sounds like a whore. Who's
no,
more
no,
like
she
it?
Never says she's down to fuck, but she...
She alludes
but
to
she,
that.
But she didn't say like, she wasn't.
You like to get that big, thick fucking back, right?
Yeah.
The big, fucking, thick, strong buffalo back. Hairy buffalo back.
She's not hairy.
Who do you think is more Cheswick right now? Would you say Fez or Crazed?
Sea Dog is more Cheswick right now.
Who do you think, Fred?
I feel like...
Because I see him, I think Fez is Chez. I see Sea Dog is Martini.
He looks like Martini, so yeah. Maybe that's... He kind of really has that early Danny DeVito look to him.
What do you think, Zitz?
I'm saying more Fez.
Oh, oh shit!
Oh, and why do you say more Fez?
Just because, I mean, he seems to more embody that whole thing.
You haven't seen it, have you?
Nope, no idea. I had no fucking idea. I'm really
what's
angry.
The, what's
crazy.
The movie called?
I think it's One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Mainly because I...
One Flew's Over.
One Flew Over. I had to drop a quarter in the DJ internet Smith? Jar to feverishly Google Chadwick Martini.
You ever saw this movie?
No. When Craze asked why Fez, I got so angry for a minute. I was just like, I'm so close to being out of this.
Why was he angry?
Because he acts like he's better than you, and he's not.
Yeah.
He's your Punchy. Yeah. Punchy said, wants to know, what time are you showing up tonight to ignore people, Fez?
I'll be ignoring Punchy at 8 o'clock tonight.
No, you're ignoring or focusing on him completely?
Oh, no. Yeah, no, I'm going to make sure everyone says hello to Punchy. I won't even talk about Idol. I'm just going to talk Punchy tonight.
I can have a DMC.
Sure.
Thanks. Fez always says, and this is for a year you've had certs in your pocket, right?
Yeah, the wintergreen flavor.
Oh, I didn't know. What other flavors are there?
Oh, there's peppermint and spearmint. And
I didn't know this.
Are those vegan?
Fruit flavored cinnamon, I think.
Are those vegan certs?
Yeah, these are vegan certs.
Of course they are.
You want one?
Yeah. No cow was hurt in the making of these certs.
I started calling them like DNCs, like not here, which is strange.
Oh, you call them that other places?
Yeah, just like, yo.
And these have been in your pocket for 1 year?
Exactly, 1 year. Don't eat them all.
How many did you take?
They got to go for another year. Let the rules have gone now.
Come on, Craze.
One I took.
Sure.
Craze, you showing up tonight to talk with Fez?
Sure, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're going to type the Interrobang.
So what do you do there?
I'm going to go www.theinterrogang.com.
Interrogang.
Well, the way he's
the Interrobang.
It's going to take him forever to get there.
www.theinterrobang.com.
He goes on a computer.
Interrobang.
He tries to draw a fish.
Interrobang.
I hope so. He gets there. What time's Idol start?
8 o'clock tonight. 2 hour tonight.
Oh, God.
2 hours? Yes.
Who can watch that shit for 2 hours?
I've never seen an episode.
Everyone should be watching Alcatraz. The 63s are coming back.
What?
No.
Are they gonna
My mom watches that show.
It's only been on once.
No, I mean American Idol.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's why its ratings
are... She wants you to get on it, right?
I could see myself on it, but I'd probably fail amazingly.
You just rap.
Because you only do rap?
I think I would be better than that guy who did I Shot the Sheriff by Bob Marley.
You think you're better than Bob Marley?
No. No, but the guy who just sang the chorus to Bob Marley's song.
All right, Fez.
Mm-hmm.
Liz can't make it tonight, and HTG is also going to be out.
Oh, that doesn't help the room.
Why? You need that feminine thing?
Yeah, they're always fun to have in there.
Right. Well, you...
They're always fun to have at a party, I would think.
But you wouldn't know that.
I've never been to a party with Liz, that's fine.
Why say it then? Why say the oddness? Anyway.
So what time is this going?
It's
going
to start at 8 o'clock tonight on the Interrobang. After the dark ban is lifted.
And what room in the Interrobang is it?
You'll see it on the front page there for American Idol.
Okay. No doubt.
I think there's huge doubts that you'll find it. HTG says, how come you never bring up Shrekalove when she's so nice to you?
I brought up Shrekalove a lot yesterday.
Oh! HTG! Face! Oh,
face.
Damn.
Look who it is. It's Jill Trucker.
Hey, Looney Tune, it's an honor to share initials with you. I was wondering if you could throw us some ones and twos.
Oh. Here I come with the ones and twos. You know what I do, cause I'm coming at you with the come to do's. And here I come with Jill the Trucker. She knows that she's no ordinary sucker. She comes at like any other motherfucker. You know what, I'm coming at you in Rutgers. Now you wanna know what I'm saying. And now I ain't really playing. with the same beat that I've been rapping over for 5 years. It ain't over now because I'm coming at you from the streets. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm on beats. I wouldn't consider Levittown from the streets, but I'm from Levittown there, you know, because I'm coming at you with the old school flow. And you know why? Because I come with the grow. Coming at you with the ones and twos. You know what I do. I come at you too. Coming at you with the beats that I use.
Redundant.
And then I do's. And then what I do's. And that's a wrap.
Fez, Ron Red Dog is asking, does somebody fill me in? Who the fuck is Punchy? And why must we endure this?
Punchy is someone with very special needs and needs special attention.
Mm-hmm.
So that likes to hang out on the Interrobang when we're doing NFL playoff wire.
The Interrobang. The Interrobang. Punchy? The Interrobang.
That's good.
What the fuck is an Interrobang anyway?
That's what everybody's asking.
That's a great question. You're going to find that out tonight.
I think it's like a symbol, and it's like a upside down horseshoe or something like
it's
that.
It's an upside down horseshoe.
Yeah.
It's for a horse that's walking backwards.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Word. Awkward silence.
Yeah, it is. It always is here. So, Fred, what are we doing? We getting back with the girl or not?
I think we might do it. I think we can get back. I think why not? Why not take a chance? Why not live the sort of rom-com lifestyle where maybe things can work out?
Will she move back to New York?
I don't know. I think we'll keep it long distance.
Where were you last time together?
Richmond. We lived in Richmond together.
And she moved up to Philly. You went up to fucking...
Yeah, we moved pretty much at the same time.
Then both of you should move to Boston now. This is a way of starting fresh.
Might not be a bad idea, but...
Please come to Boston.
The Boston loves you. Do, 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 do. Yeah. Coming through to Boston. Gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country. Gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Moving to the country. Gonna eat me a lot of peaches. Yeah.
This is vegan.
That's good, Chris.
Yeah, that was really good.
Onion enough presents.
I have to say, that video kicks ass.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen that video where the ninjas are trying to steal the peaches?
Mm-hmm. 16 years ago, I saw it. Here's Mike.
Yeah, my friends told me I should call and see if I could get on the retard show today. Can I get on?
Why don't you shut the fuck up?
That's not very nice. They told me it would be funny.
Smile your school again, Crazed. That's what they used to do to Looney Tunes.
Yeah, this guy thinks he's funny, but he really ain't.
I feel like a sick burn on you, or did you just roll off?
Yep.
We got a break?
Yeah.
All right. Be right back. Run a Fez. Run a Fez show. On a Wednesday. Tomorrow, Hicks will lift the ban off the internet. We will be able to freely move it around the internet again.
Word.
Fez, the guys were working with you during a commercial break. Craze was giving you advice. What advice are you taking from
him? To let things roll off of my shoulders.
And you feel like that's good advice?
Well, I guess it's better than letting them hang on your shoulders.
Anybody just don't else? let the guy stress you out, you know?
And this is like group. You never wanted to be in group, right? Though, right, Fez?
I was in a group once, and I think it was the psychologist leading it. It was a really non-helpful experience.
Mm. Well, you want to try it here? Tell everybody what's bothering you.
Yeah, that I tried to do something nice and fun that I enjoyed, and then I feel like someone tried to just spoil it. When I was having a nice positive, like, that's what people keep telling me, to be positive and have fun and get out there. I did it. And then, you know, then it's not good enough and people start complaining.
But it didn't take away from the fun stuff that actually happened.
And here, by the way, we're right back to where we were before the commercial break. It's the old Fez nagging about that thing and doing the Mikey D. You know, you've turned this guy into your Mikey D. You haven't found a new boy about it. And it doesn't sound like that, you know. It doesn't sound fun to me. You don't sound like the fun hostess. Where are you at on this, Crazed?
I think, you know, a lot of the times, Fez just sits back, you know, and lets all the weight on your shoulders run.
I didn't even think of that.
You know, and sometimes he needs to chime in more, and it's not the Ron show; it's right. The Ron and Fez show.
I didn't even think of that. How'd we end up here, Fez?
I have no idea because Crazed wasn't following the conversation.
I was.
But sometimes the simplest.
That wasn't what we were talking about, Crazed.
It's still.
Simplest answers are the
right.
The most deep. And
I mean, was he wrong?
No, he's right.
And I think, you know, that with Punchy, I think he is a little needy, but Fez needs to kind of respect that, you know, but you know, just, I guess you can accommodate his needs, but you can't always accommodate everybody's needs.
Right.
Because there's so many people.
Mm. Do you agree with that, Tix? Because I noticed you've been kind of quiet in group today. Well, you still taking a lot of pills?
When I had my group therapy, I just lied every time. Like, oh, yeah, I'm still sober.
Isn't that like every... yeah, you treat it like every relationship you've ever been in.
No.
Pez, do you feel like this is helpful, or does it still feel like it's pulling away from you?
No, it's helpful.
What part? Crazed? Or when fucking Hicks just said he's lying? I haven't heard a helpful thing yet. We got HTG.
Hey, guys.
The happy typing girl.
Hey, Debster.
Oh, Debster.
It's phone in a group session.
Hey,
all right.
Hey, dog. How's it going?
Chilling like a villain. Like a guy who's willing.
All right.
There you go.
All right. I don't want to cause trouble for anybody here.
Oh, good.
I want to say, I was in that chat, and it was a lot of fun. And Fez, by the way, it was hysterical. Really, really funny.
Thank you.
But I think you might have gotten a misread on this whole Punchy thing, because Punchy was a riot. And I, you know, I don't want to be against you, but I was, you know, I was writing back to Punchy all the time. If you go look at that thing, you'll see it. Punchy was really funny. I think this somehow got on the wrong foot.
Oh.
All right, I was wrong.
Oh.
Well, you don't have to take my word for it, but I think that if you look back, you'll see that Punchy wasn't trying to be a dick.
No, I mean today. I was complimentary about Punchy today.
Oh, all right.
I'm talking about when start sending stuff in. Today, saying that I refuse to talk to people.
Well, maybe he didn't mean that as like a, you know, you were, maybe he didn't mean it in the way of you're being an asshole or she. Maybe they meant it just as, you know, hey, you know, I would have liked it if Fez talked to me. Because I saw there was one other guy, like Twizzle was saying, it was the highlight of his life to be able to be back and forthing with Fez Wally.
That's sad. I mean, Twizzles must have the worst fucking life ever.
Yeah, I do it every day, and it's like, you know, it's okay.
Oh, shit!
Fuck!
Isn't it time for you to have another cyst removed?
Oh,
you've actually been here one day.
Oh, jeez.
This is why we can't have nice things.
No. It's Mikey D all over. All right, so maybe, you know, we were all mad at Punchy, but maybe we got off on the wrong foot here.
I'm just saying, like, people who showed up, let's give them a chance. And, you know, I mean, people are nervous getting to actually communicate with you. Maybe, you know, they just need a little encouragement from you to be cool. And then, you know, if they keep being an asshole, then, you know, that's fine. But just make sure that they're against you before you, you know. I don't think the guy was against you. I really don't.
All right, HDJ.
All right.
Take care, Debster.
We will miss you tonight.
Oh, yeah.
I like having HDG there.
Tonight's going to be fireworks,
I'm
sure.
I will miss you, too.
Oh, wow. Sexy dog. James, go ahead.
Hey, I just want to ask Craze why he fucking stutters so much, and please shoot that motherfucker and get him out.
All right, hold on. Yeah, have you gotten that before, Craze?
Yeah. I just sometimes get... When I get anxious or I get a little nervous sometimes on the air, I stutter.
Look, Crazed. People try to put you down. But it's just because you get around.
Yeah, exactly.
You should be talking about your generation. Fred, why do you turn around and laugh? Why
like
can't you laugh straight in?
Sorry.
Because at first you thought it was real and I was trying to help.
And then it went into song lyrics.
Explain it to Fez. I would love for Fez to get it.
Well, the way Ron was talking was like...
Mark, you're in front of Fez.
Yeah, Fezzy, life lesson. Crazed, whose life is, let's face it, he's an abortion that lived. He's a horror show. He's happier than you. He's happier than you. You're a successful radio show host. Come on, brother. He's a disaster, and listen to him. He's got joy in his voice. He loves to live life.
Everybody's different.
Oh, come on, buddy.
Doesn't make sense, Fezzy. That means that you don't have to get better. But he is a happy guy. And I'll tell you this. I'm not kidding.
But I've had my down spells where I'm really depressed.
Never.
I've had.
Never. You're always happy. Craze, we love having you in here.
Awesome.
When are you coming back again? Can you come back next week?
I
what's going to take?
I don't know. I mean, I'll definitely try to come down. Definitely I'll try, yeah.
What about the next time you come down, head out to the movies after and see something?
All right, definitely.
You know, because you're a movie man, right?
Yeah.
You love movies.
And I'll call in the next time and I'll give it a review.
Oh.
Wow.
Nice.
This is big.
This is big shit.
This is big Crazed at the movies.
What's with you keeping a fucking pen up under your hat
right
next to your eyeball?
I keep the pen next to my hat now.
Seriously. You look like a fucking burial motherfucker. Over
chilling
there.
Out with his vegan popcorn.
Oh! Shit!
God damn!
I refuse to eat vegan.
I can just tell you, no one can top that line. Let's just fucking end it with chilling with his vegan popcorn. That's fucking LOD. Alright?
Take care. Peace!
There he goes. He says peace to you. You can join Craze tonight. He'll be hosting in the entire bang, American Idol. You're going to be there by 8, Crazed?
Yup.
Or like everything else.
8:45.
Half-assed and a dollar short. Anything else we need to plug?
Go to theentirebank.com tonight.
At 8.
At 8 p.m.
Not a second before.
Get there.
8 p.m. at the Interabang.
Fezzy, you got anything you want to plug?
Nope, that was it. We got it out there. That's the end.